To use the Inspire to construct a histogram, you want to go to the home screen and choose a new document, which is option number one. And then we have to put data into the calculator, so we're going to add a list or spreadsheet, which is option number four. And so I see my spreadsheet page, which is also my list page, and in the Inspire, all lists have to have names. And so I'm going to toggle up to the A column and give this list a name. So I'm looking at page 78 in the statistics book, and there's an example there about arrival times at Wendy's. So maybe I'm just going to call this list W. So I'll remember that means Wendy's. And I'm going to toggle down to the first entry and start keying in the data that I see on page 78. So there's a 7 and then 6 and a 6 and a 6 and a 4 and a 6 and a 2 and a 6. And that's the first row. And we're just going to continue through that chart until I have all of my data entered into this list. So I just keep doing that. I'm about to be at the end of the second row. And I just keep going. And so I'm coming up on the end of the third row of the data set. Starting the fourth row. And finally, I'm getting to the last row. And I will soon have all of the data for Wendy's in list A. So it's quite a long list. I have 40 pieces of data. And to have the calculator produce a histogram, I go back and I want to add a page, so I do control and doc, and the page that I want to add is number 5 for data and statistics. And when that page pops open, I see all of these little dots on my screen, and those are my data values that I just entered. And so what I want to do is just kind of scroll down to the bottom of the page. I'm going to click on the little box here that says click to enter or add the variable. And over to the right, it gives me choices. Now, if I had more than one list entered, then I would be able to choose here different ones. But this is my Wendy's list, so I'm just going to hit enter to choose it. And you'll see the dots, the data, just rearrange themselves into sort of a dot plot. But I want a dot plot, I want a histogram. And so I come back to menu, and I choose plot type, which is number 1, and I scroll down and choose the histogram plot, which is number 3. And you'll see the dots kind of rearrange themselves into these bars. And of course, the bars are connected, looking at a histogram. And I see the histogram that looks remarkably similar to the one that you'll see on page 80 in your book. Now, this looks like our bin width is 1, and the alignment of the bars are on the half. So it starts at a half, and then 1.5, and then 2.5, and then 3.5, and 4.5. If you ever want to change something about that, you would just click on menu, and then plot properties, number 2, histogram properties, and then bin settings. And you can choose, say, number 1, equal bin width. And you can change the width of those columns, and you can change their alignment. You can have them start on the holes, you know, which would be 1, and it would run from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, or anything in between. This one is pretty nice, so I've got the bars centered over the values. And so I like this one pretty well. So I'm just going to escape here, and there's the histogram.